Maybe you'll find a casino. I don't need this. This is just a casino. You can play mini games. That's all it is. So I don't need to go here. Actually, I did. Hey guys and gals, I'm Pal, and welcome back to Super Paper Mario. Last time, I got up to floor 75 of the Samur Kingdom, and I ended it there. This time, we're by all means, we're going to be doing that, but I realized that I forgot to cover the casino, the arcade. I don't know what it's called, but I assume we are going to find out. Oh, I am most pleased. Another gaming customer has found us. Welcome to the Palace of Gaming Pleasure, the arcade. I am the master of this fine establishment. You may call me the Interchet. It is a pleasure to rob you. I mean, to meet you. Now that the introductions are out of the way, let me tell you about this place. This is the arcade, a place for gamers to enjoy gaming. To play games, you must first purchase Flipside tokens. Come see me with a few coins, and I will give you the tokens you need. But you cannot return tokens for coins, so be careful. Oh, so careful, gamer. And once you have some tokens, enter this neato entry to the left. You may play fun games until you run out of tokens. You will love it, gamer. But now I have crucial information. Get a good score to receive tokens back. Collect a lot of tokens and turn them in for wonderful prizes. Play the games, get good, and then earn prizes, gamer. Ah, the arcade, it is paradise. That ends my explanation. So, do you see how wonderful this place is, gamer? I mean, I've never really actually done an arcade. So, I mean, sure, I'll give it a shot. A gamer seeks entertainment. What can I do for you? Let's see what kind of items I'll get. A mystery box, those can be pretty cool. An ultra shroom shake, that's nice. A whack-a-bump, a mazy daisy. Interesting. Wait, what? What? It gives me a level up? Just instantly? For free? Wow, okay, so, I mean, they cost 2,500 tokens, but, man, that's nice. The Interchet looks forward to your next fabulous visit, Relentless Gamer. Okay, I would like to actually buy some tokens, because what good is making this video if I can't lose all my money making tokens and then pawning them off? You want to trade 150 tokens for 50? Yes, I want it. Is 50 enough? Let's just assume that 50's enough. What's in here? What can I get? This seems sort of like Merlee's castle, and that I'm blowing my money on random stuff. There's Forget-Me-Not Mansion Patrol and Tilt Island. Well, let's start with the first one. This game takes 10 Flipside tokens. Give it a whirl. Let's learn how to play first. Flip panels over with A to find two of the same picture. Find all the pairs to clear around. But mess up three times in a row, or three times in a round, and your game is over. Sure, I'll play. Point that at the screen. Alright, how I do? Okay, I think I got it. Maybe. This one is Merlee. And then that one's Merlee. Cool. And then this one was Count Black. And so is that one. I'm racking up mad combos here. And then I can't possibly get this one wrong. They're both Peach. Alright. I'm actually really bad at this game. This kind of game. So, at concentration. So, we'll see how I do. Round two. Whoa. You can't do that. Ooh, a change of scenery. Bowser, Bowser, Luigi, Luigi, Black, Black. Okay. Bowser, Bowser. No, no, no. It was this one. Bowser, Bowser. Luigi, Luigi? Yeah, yeah. And then these ones were Black. No, they weren't. What? Oh, wait, was this one? Yeah, this one was. Okay. So that one's Black. Cool. What is this one? Oh, these ones are both Bestovius. And these ones are Merlee. Maybe I'm better at this than I thought, or it's just easy. I'm not sure. And really, it showed me the last ones? I know, game. It can't possibly not be those. Why would you show that to me? All right, round six. I honestly didn't think it was going to go this long. I thought I was going to fail pretty quickly. No, okay. Oh, boy. Nope, I failed it. Well, I got to round seven, which is pretty good. I got a lot of points. How many points exactly? I got 18 tokens. Also, those tokens look mysteriously and suspiciously like the rubies that you got from Mimi. So that's kind of suspect. So as a bit of backstory while I'm going through here, we'll learn how to play. I'm actually recording this segment of the episode a day before it comes out, and I think 2 or 3 weeks after I recorded the quote-unquote final episode. I mean, it is the final episode, but I had to record this for it because I forgot that I needed to include this in the videos. Take aim at those pesky boos with A and drive them away. Wait too long and the boos will close in and damage you. Stay alive to advance. If a boo hits you 3 times, you can kiss your tokens goodbye. Okay, I can do that. I believe that there are more mini games than we see on screen here. I think. I'm pretty sure you can unlock a couple of them. But I'm not really interested in doing that today. I'm just interested in getting the vanilla set that this game has to offer. Missed? Okay. Can I miss infinitely? Oh, I can. Oh, that's easy. Okay. Die. And you, what am I playing? Am I playing Skyward Sword all of a sudden? With all of these point and click things? Although the motion controls for that were much better than in this game. Okay. Sick it on me, yo. I can, no. Oh boy. Oh, you lose points if you hit Toad. All right. A bit of a difficulty spike, but nothing I can't handle. I have to be very good on my aim here. Dash dance for mobility. Just go back and forth, and that doesn't actually work, by the way. That's not how shooters work. Come on. Hit me with your best shot. Where's King Boo? And also, this is... Oh, snap. I killed the Toad. No. Got it. Yes. Oh, I have a power-up. Oh, wow. Where did I get a power-up? I don't know. But I got one. Maybe... Oh, I saved the Toad. That's why. Oh, that's cool. Okay, I'm going to save Toads from now on. No. Don't you think you can come near me? Round cleared. That was pretty easy. I mean, once I figured out that not killing Toad is a good thing. A special Boo? I don't know what he did, but I killed him. Also, since when are Boos weak to guns? And what am I even shooting him with? Is it a gun? Is it a vacuum? Is it a gun vacuum cleaner? Is it a vacuum, or is it a gun that shoots vacuum cleaners? I got a combo! Oh man, I'm racking up all the combo points. Oh, I missed. Alright, so consecutive hits give a combo. So there is a punishment for missing, and it's just getting fewer points. Back up them sick combos. Good shot. Okay, the star's kind of lame. I like the multi-shot ability more so than anything. Okay, just multi-fire here. Whoa! Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy, oh boy. What is that? How do I get that away? Okay, I got him. Wow. Oh, do I just have 1 hit point? Oh, I have just 1 hit point. Okay. I can work with that, though I don't think I'll last very long. Especially with all the purple boos around. Man, I'd love to see a tool-assisted speedrun of this mode. That'd be fun. See how high you could get. That'd be really cool. And also to see how far they programmed the modes. Oh boy. Oh, I'm dead. Wow, that was kind of intense, but enjoyable. I will not say that it wasn't, because that would be lying. I also appreciate, did I say it? I appreciate that they put the Luigi's Mansion 1 lobby in here. You see that? The stairs, the chandelier that's in the process of falling. It's really cool. Granted, the picture frames weren't there, but this is indeed the Luigi's Mansion Season 1 Lobby. Also, do you see that over there? Look, so you see these webs, how they're cut off right here and right here? Have I ever talked about that? I don't think I have. This game was originally intended to be on GameCube, and you can see that that is actually the 4x3 aspect ratio cutoff area, and they just extended the stairs on the right and left. That's actually kind of cool. So this was made, that mode was made before the game was transferred over to Wii. That's really interesting. Alright, last game for the episode before I get to the real meat of the episode, meat of the video, rather. And that is Flipside, what is it called? Tilt Island. Tilt the Wiimote to dodge the falling enemies and grab the tasty desserts. Get a certain number of desserts to clear the round. But if you get hurt 3 times, your game is over. Okay, I can do that. Also, I'd like to point out that just like any casino, I have 53 tokens right now, and I started with 50. So the whole 2,500 reward for those are enemies. The 2,500 reward for getting the items that help me level up. That's kind of a pipe dream. I didn't realize that was a pun, but yeah, it is kind of a pun. Okay, I guess I should focus more on getting the benefits here. There we go. Alright, so I just have to get 5 items and then the round's over. Okay, I can deal with that. Start round 2. I honestly expected the Wiimote to be a little bit more janky with the tilt physics here, but it's actually doing rather well, considering this game was programmed with the Wiimote, the vanilla Wiimote, not the Wiimote Plus. Also, how did I miss that? Okay, just grab the fruit thing. Grab that. Run over to grab the peach. And one more piece of food. Oh, that's all I need. Whoa. Getting some pro dodges in here. And grab that. Nice. All right. This feels like a Nintendo Land game. It really does, which is not a bad thing. Nintendo Land had some great games, especially Donkey Kong's Crash Course. That one's a blast. It's a bramble blast. Ho, 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 ho. Let's just pace back and forth. And get hungry by all of this food falling from the sky. As if it being the day before Thanksgiving when I'm recording this isn't torturous enough whenever someone mentions gravy or turkey or any food in general. This game has to show me a bunch of beautiful desserts that I'd love to be eating right now. Grab that and grab that. Tilting the platform actually brings you closer to the thing you might be trying to dodge, so you have to be really careful. What on earth? What do I have? What is this? What was that, Mario? You became a ballerina. That's not cool. You don't... No. That's a spin-off game for later. When you play the Olympic sports with Sanic. It feels kind of weird commentating again, because I've been taking a break since school has been flooding me, and to start commentating again feels weird. It also felt weird because this Monday, I actually did a speech for my speech class about prison and how we should all try to get into prison and how you should get into prison. It was pretty great, but it made me miss commentating, and it made me realize how odd I become when I'm not doing a Let's Play. I become really strange. Like, every now and then I'll just have the urge to commentate something. Even if it's in the middle of me doing something, I'll talk to myself. And it just makes me more prone to vocalizing my thoughts. So maybe that's a bad thing. Wow, that was close. But yeah, sometimes I'll just randomly talk to myself and I'm like, wait a minute, where'd that come from? That isn't normal. And then I answer, oh, you're not Let's Playing. You're a weird person when you're not Let's Playing. I think my friends have noticed. Let's Playing has become a healthy thing for me now. It's become a thing that I can't imagine not doing anymore. As I said in the year 2 anniversary video, which was a while back. We're already almost up to the 3rd anniversary, which is crazy. It also looks like I haven't been that productive because I slowed down my upload schedule. So now it's only 2 videos a week. What does that even do? I'm tempted to get hit just to see what it... Oh, okay, it does. It gives you invincibility. Oh, wow. That's really good. Oh, that's really strong. Okay. So now I know what that does. Let's just keep grabbing them because this is nice. Look how many points I'm getting. Wow. And let's grab that to finish off the round. I'm really doing too well when using a tilting control method, of all things. Of course, I did also play Mario Kart. I was the one guy who played Mario Kart Wii with the Wii wheel. I honestly don't know why. And I've tried playing it with the... Oh, that was my first hit. I could not have dodged that. I tried playing it with a GameCube controller, and I just couldn't. It felt so foreign. Ugh. So, to this day, whenever I play Mario Kart Wii, I still use the Wii wheel. Just gently walk. Gently walk, pal. Wow. Wow, that was a dodge. Star? Okay. I'll take a star. Oh, it makes it so it only drops food. That's cool. Let's grab food. I need to end this round as quickly as possible. The difficulty spike was very severe with this round. Dodge everything! Just need two more food items. Two more food items. Not going to grab that one. Just going to dodge enemies. Going to wait for it to come to me. Wait for my magical day in the sun. There's one. Run. Run. Oh, dangerous games are what I'm playing right now. I don't think I'm going to get up to a million, but I'm definitely putting in some serious work on this round as opposed to the other ones. Just do that. Grab that. They're just kind of... They're hand-feeding me right now. I should have gone for the sleepy sheep. Oh, boy. That's kind of concerning. Oh, boy. Wow. Oh, that was dumb. That was all me. I just kind of... I was so impressed with my last dodge that I just kind of let go on life at that point. But hey, whoa! They did not intend for you to make it that long. 54 flipside tokens earned. Cool. Okay. I can deal with that. And I'm fourth place. Man, Mort, Hort, and Muffy did better than I did? Are you kidding me? Come on, I deserve credit for that. Okay, well, that's the arcade. I don't know how much of the video I took up, but hopefully not a lot. Let's trade these for items. What's the best item we can get? A shooting star. A shooting star. Okay, so apparently you're going to have to put so many hours into doing the arcade that it would just be worth it to go and jump on a Koopa for like 20 minutes to get a level up. Okay, well, there's that. What do these guys say? Let me talk to you. My plan was to slip out of town while my girlfriend was fast asleep, but she caught me, and I tell you, gamer, it was not pretty. I need a new plan. How can I get out of town unnoticed? Heh. Actually, planning this is pretty fun. Well, that's not a good thing to plan, but whatever. Oh boy, listen to this. The video game gods finally smiled down on me. I was trying to get a high score before the world ended, and I did it with ease. Now I earn flipside tokens like crazy. I trade them for prizes and sell those. I can't believe how good I am now. But hey, do what you love, that's what they say. I paid back my loan and now I can even visit home to see my girl after all these years. Yeah, I'll get on this. Get on that. Real soon. But first, I gotta play one more time. Okay. Sure. Well, that's the arcade, everyone. And that's actually the last bit of the Let's Play I am recording chronologically. But that's not the last you get to see, because I have yet to finish in this video the Samur Kingdom. So, I guess I'll bid you adieu. And let future or past pal take over. All right, hit it, past pal. Welcome back to Chapter 6-4 as my throat grows hoarse. I've been recording all of this in one sitting, and man, I have to stop every couple of rooms just to take a drink of water and convince myself that the pain in my throat will not last. Slow are my feet, sharp are my spikes. I am guardian of the 76th gate, the one known as Wandering Spiny. Born from the clouds, I wander the earth alone, I punish all things. And I'm green, which means I am clearly Link. Even though I'm actually Link. I actually accidentally did my Link cosplay today, which I realized also I've bragged about that thing since Skyward Sword. Since the first Let's Play, and I've never actually shown a picture of it on screen, so if I have time to take a picture of it, I will definitely pop it up on screen, but I actually accidentally wore it because I left it at my church. I originally wore it to help out with their Harvest Fest, where they, you know, they invite kids over, and they have a bunch of different events and games and stuff, and I think over 1,000 people come in and out throughout the night, and so I help with that. And I felt, originally when I did it, I felt obligated to make a cosplay, and so I made a Link cosplay, which is actually pretty good if you saw the pictures on screen. And so yeah, I did that, and I accidentally left part of it there with someone because I locked myself out of my car. I went in, I left it running, and then went inside to go grab Nova, and wow, I womboed him. I went in to grab Nova, finding that she was already gone, and then I went back and tried to unlock the car with the fob, and it locked me out. Which really, I mean, it wasn't my fault. It's not like I locked the keys inside. I had the fob with me, but yeah, that was kind of stunk, so I had to stand outside for a while. Which really surprised me, because I had, you know, no warmth other than my tunic and, you know, what I had on me. And I still didn't get sick, even though I was, you know, out there at 12 at night. Or, no, it was earlier than that. It was more like 10 or 11. But, yeah, I'm actually pretty surprised that I have not gotten sick thus far this season. If you guys recall, in past years, I've gotten pretty sick around this time, around October. I remember 2 years ago, October 20th, I believe, October 20th, a bunch of stuff happened to me back in Okami. There were some personal things, but also some physical things, as I got tonsillitis. I'm trying to remember the list. Tonsillitis, a sore throat in addition to the tonsillitis, the flu, let's see, a common cold, pink eye, oh yeah, and then I had a double ear infection. So I had an inner-outer ear infection in both ears, which led to a complete upper respiratory infection. Ironically, it was actually around the same time that Chugga Conroy had the same thing. And so that was terrible. I was left deaf for about a month, which was actually it was a little bit scary for me because, you know, you're deaf, you can't hear, and you have no clue when it's going to end. But yeah, that was a crazy time. It really was. And I managed to record some episodes during that time. So if you go around the October episodes of Okami, you will find a very, very sick paladin recording episodes, managing to cough out some words, even though he can't even hear the words he's speaking. Those were times. And then the next year, almost to the day, on October... Wait, just a second. I am Bullet Bill. All colors fill me with wrath. You will not pass the 87th gate. I long for the sweet peace of the pasture, but the white colors of the world taunt me. Why must all things be so bright? Why can things not appear only in hues of brown? I am so serious about this. Dull colors are the future, the next generation. Is this Nintendo making fun of next-gen games like, you know, Skyrim and stuff like that? Is this guy just a really big fan of Fallout 4? Your bright clothes doom you. At high speed, I will I blast into your face. Charge! Okay, so this guy really likes Fallout 4. I got it. Oh boy. I don't want to use my life shroom. Let's use the super shroom shake. And jump and berry. Nope, not jump and berry. Do that instead. Yeah, on October 20th the next year, I was also sick with tonsillitis again to the day. I've been sick 2 years running with tonsillitis, but I managed to beat it this year. Despite all the crazy things I've been doing, I mean, I've been kind of abusing my body recently with staying outside while I'm locked out of my car, and I believe the church was locked up too, so I was just outside. And, yeah, and then other times I went to Puget Sound, and I was close to getting an ear infection. I don't think I would have gotten one, but I was kind of close, because Puget Sound has never really agreed with me. And then That same day, I was up late watching the League of Legends viewing party, and I was up at 1 o'clock at night. Yeah, man, I've been living the college life, staying up way too late, and beating myself up. Literally, no, not literally, actually. I have not been beating myself up. That would be a little bit ridiculous, but I've not been taking care of my body as well as I should have. Alright, so you are going to jump in Kamehameha. That's new. It's also not a Kamehameha, it's more of a spirit bomb. But, I mean, that's... people recognize Kamehameha a little bit more than spirit bomb, so I stick with that. Alright, through next door, we're up to floor what now? Or room what? 82? 83? We're getting close to the end of the Let's Play, which is crazy, but... and I'll save my thoughts for when that happens, but we're 85th, wow. And this guy has a cold. That's sad. Well, let's beat the cold out of him, I guess. And he's sneezing too! He's sneezing out his cold. Sniff! Ooh, sniff, sniff! That beating completely cleared my cold up. I am now unplugged, sniff it. I thank you. Aw, we cured his cold! And he's happy. Oh, that's great. I feel good about myself. Colds are not fun. Although, I like sore throats less, because in case it wasn't obvious to you, I like to talk. And so, anything that impedes my ability to talk is not a good thing. You've come to the 86th gate. Have you come seeking Bounding Star? You have found him. Have you not yet laid a hand on him, however? Always will I bound. Just out of reach, follow me to your end, for I am invincible. Are you really? Are you really? Ooh, boy. This guy is fast. Oh, boy. No, no. Yeah, hit him. My invincibility ran out. I know how it feels. You're using your invincibility, and then it runs out, and you're like, man, I wish I had invincibility and a sandwich, and you just die. It's sad. Okay, let's use a long last shake, as I think more about sandwiches, because sandwiches are nice. They're also a funny thing to talk about in online, because they're, you can talk about random things and people will become your friend. I remember once I was trying to get a position in League and I asked if I could switch positions because I was mid and I wanted jungle. And he said, what will you give me? And I said, cookies. And he was like, what kind of cookies? I said, sandwich cookies. They're made from sandwiches. And he gave me the position because I promised him cookies made of sandwiches. And it's fun. Being random online can definitely work. Or you could pretend you're a girl online, and that a lot of people do that. And it's actually really easy. All you have to do is spam emotes in chat or in comments, and people will think you're a girl for whatever reason. I'm not saying it's a stereotype. I'm just saying if you do it, people will think you are a girl. And they will ask you if you're a girl. And if you answer with a smiley face, or any face, they will definitely think you are a girl. Okay, let's continue on as I continue to give you bad internet advice. Drumble, belly of the Yoshi, god of the 88th gate hungers. I consume all, many have come before you, and they have all met their end. Will your cries be succulent, or will they be bitter and lacking in flavor? Chow time! Okay, I guess it's chow time. Reminds me of Animal Crossing. I actually started playing some more Animal Crossing New Leaf because I forgot that I had, you know, about a million bells, and so I've been spending them on a lot of public works projects and making my town beautiful. And it's been pretty fun, but I made one of my, because every now and then, your animal neighbors will ask you, you know, can you make a new catchphrase for me? And I will say, you know, sure, I'll do it, and they'll give a random thing for them. And this time, whenever one of my neighbors, his name's Elmer, ends a sentence, he yells at the top of his lungs, slam jam. So he's just like, oh man, I had breakfast today. It was really good. Slam jam! And it's really great. It's pretty funny. Also, I want to read him. I should have charged. Then I would have something in my pocket besides shame. Shame and lint. That's not untrue. There is lint in pockets, and it's there. So you spoke truth. And it was very funny truth, because it was true. Truisms that are truthful are funny. Okay, you wish to ascend higher, but you will not do so at the expense of climbing vine. I am the way to the sky, but you will not see it. You will not pass the 90th gate. You will gaze upward at platforms and distant clouds, wondering how to reach them. I know the way, and I will never breathe it to your ear. Your ascent ends here. And the 90th fight begins. Ow, that hurt. No. Die. Get juggled by yourself. Yeah. No. Reflect. Got him. I wither. You have climbed over many foes in this world, and I am but the latest. I am but a ladder you used to go higher, and I know not what waits above. Whatever you find ahead, may you cherish it, for few have laid eyes upon it. Alright, we're on the last 10 floors of the game. Oh boy. It honestly hasn't gotten that much more difficult. There are enemies that move faster, and they deal a little bit more damage, but they're not that threatening, really. I protect the 91st gate. I am Quizmo Question that has no answer. Who builds the pipes of our worlds? How does one put a coin in a brick? How can one bounce off another man's head? And how can one wield flame? Where do bottomless pits lead? Are overalls still considered fashionable? Ponder these questions as you taste my power. I am Flint Craggly, Crag Trotter. Hoy-yah! I kind of wish you had a face cam there, because there are certain voices that I make that the facial expressions are just... they're so good. How could I lose? Why do I have no memory of yesterday? Where do I live? What is the meaning of it all? There must be answers. Like, there... That voice, for example, I move my jaw all over creation for that one, and it's quite ridiculous. And then for the, Willard Warstash voice, I also do that. And then, of course, there's the Popo voice, which you remember fondly from Wind Waker, and that one has a very special facial expression. You have finally found me. I am strolling Patooey. I guard the 92nd gate. Few have seen me, warrior. My native land was known as World 7-8. There I learned at the hand of my master, Walking Patooey. He spat fire. I spit wrath, and you shall be the one who is spat upon. Like that voice requires a very sadistic smile. And really, if you have the smile down, you can do the voice. It's really as easy as that. You cannot make the voice without the smile. It's actually not possible. In fact, I'll try it. You have spat upon my technique. My master would be spitting mad at such a defeat. He would spit angry words. See, I can't do it without the smile. It just doesn't work. And so he should, for I am not worthy of his leg. See, I am blue, and I will haunt you in your sleep. And I'll go through the door and use a different voice, because that voice is fun to use, but it's kind of a Tingle exclusive. I can't just throw that voice around for everyone. I only did it for that guy because we'll never see him again. I must congratulate you on reaching the 93rd gate. You are formidable. You're also unfortunate, for you will be lunched upon by me, Fuzzy on Face. My attacks will leech your very essence. I am bound upon you without remorse. I will chew upon your hat. I will bite your forehead. I will snack upon your soul. I can only hope that you have seasoned yourself well, so that I do not grow ill. Is your face ready? Then let us do battle. I'm from the South. South people are... They're cannibals. I'll tell you. They're cannibals. Fire. Yeah, that strategy actually works. stunning them with Barry and then just holding down. That can work. I almost hide my face. I cannot believe you defeated me. What is your secret? Do you have fuzziness on your face already? I must know the answer. I am small, and I'm actually red. That's a strange coincidence that I gave a southern voice to a guy who was literally red. He literally had a red neck. Okay. All right, we're getting close. Another rainbow guy, and another guy that flips through space-time, so he's really easy to defeat. You have reached the 90-volt gate. The end is near for you. As you now must face the gaudy, gilded Glitzblade. Fear not, challenger, for you will die today with pizzas. I know that says pizzazz, but it's better to imagine that he says, fear not, challenger, for you will die today with pizzas. Pizzas kill people. People don't kill people. Pizzas kill people. And he's dead with my transdimensional fire. You have tarnished my glitz. I bow to your skill. With heavy heart, I cast away my bejeweled helmet. I do not deserve to wear it, for you are the glitziest in all the land. And now, thank you. I've seen your selection, and... I see you were trying to make a selection, and then you had some trouble with the keypad. Thank you for selecting exotic butters. Or casual bongos. Tanuki! The feral howl of Cloak of Tanuki grips you with shaggy terror. One moment will lee, the next sheer granite. I guard the 95th gate with beastly regi. What side will you face? Unshorn animal or rigid statue? Tanuki! Does he actually have Tanuki abilities, or no? That was so simple and so sad. I took a couple steps back and he was walking with a walker trying to reach us. I'm just like, well, you want a light? I mean, since you have a walker, you probably smoke. And then I just lit him on fire. That's really sad. If only I actually had a pixel that could do that for me. The Tanuki is a rare animal. Even more rare is a victoru against eat. Savor this great conquest, interloper, for the shaggy best is not easily tamed. No, it is not. No, it is not. Those are true words. Also, yeah, let's use a super shroom shake. I do not want to take 9 damage and lose my life shroom. That thing I'm saving for an emergency, man. And I need an emergency to show up for me to use it. Alright, there's another simple guy. Kneel, worthless dog, before the 96th gate. I am Coin Harvester without remorse. Do you enjoy your free time? Do you enjoy lounging about playing games? You will enjoy nothing. Once I have bested you, I will put you to work gathering wealth for me. You will eat the grit of road dust as your ceaseless toil flows without ebb. I will recline and enjoy tasty noodles bought with the very sweat of your brow. Now I harvest your soul. Man, this guy's actually antagonistic. And he's also very... No. I meant to say, I'm sorry, I spoke out of turn. I need to not taunt people before I win. I was going to say, excuse me, I was going to say, he's also very dead.
Yerk!
Was it my fault I lost? I forgot his voice already.
No, of course not. I just need much better equipment and more harvesters. Do you know anyone willing to work for little pay, no benefits, and verbal abuse?
Yes. I mean, probably. I could give me time. I could probably think of someone as you perform ballerina moves. You know, actually, come to think of it, I probably have some Goombas that were not loyal to me, and they were loyal to Count Black, which makes me wonder: are the first enemies you see in Mario games? Are they Goombas not because they're weak, but because they're just not loyal, so they're sent out first? That's a theory for MatPat, everyone. Spam him. I want to hear some Goomba theories. What is their true motivation? Do they feel love? Do they hate people? What are they truly the villains? Or are they the heroes? I don't know. But MatPat could probably twist the game in such a way that we could believe whatever it is he said. Look, Skyward Challenger, I am Pidgeot on Wind's Breath, protector of the 97th gate. There is without master, and I float upon paths on its whimsy. Yeah, sure. Yeah, you have blankets. You do that. I don't have anything against MatPat. Although, well, that's not true. Wow, he's definitely spams. I don't have anything against MatPat other than the whole YouTube Red thing, because I kind of feel like... I feel like YouTube Red isn't that good for YouTube. Originally, I was fairly neutral on YouTube Red's health for the Let's Playing and content creator community. But I feel like now that it's had time to develop, it is not a good thing. Because I think, from what I understand, YouTube revenue has gone down. Because of YouTube Red, and that's just, that's not a good thing. You shouldn't have to get YouTube Red series to make money off of YouTube. The whole purpose of YouTube is to make your own content and let, I guess, capitalism decide which people are successful, and, I don't know, it's just... Whoa, hello, man. You deal... No, wait. I see you're dealing damage. I mean, that's cool. Just deal it when I have less, or I have more health. Okay. Are you dead? He's dead. And I dealt 60 damage to him as well. You are ungrateful. Well, I'm sorry, but you didn't really give me anything except a firm beating. You are young and lazy. You do not value the lesson of your sensei. No matter. You will learn the lesson of humility with your next challenge. Well, I hope so, because... this inventory is not making things look that tense. It really isn't. But yeah, YouTube Red just isn't really... I'm not impressed with it. If I can make words come out of my mouth. I am Pit of Crying Shames, Crusher of Hopes, Stomper of Dreams. To fight me is to fight 100 fearsome, slobbering warriors. Many have gathered to conquer me. All leave with tear-stained cheeks. Those who challenge me here at the 99th gate have much to lose. It makes their sad, sad tears all the sweeter to drink. Slurp. Alright, floor 99. This is almost it. It's not quite it. I'll save that honor and the honor of a sick voice that I concocted it when he was talking for the last room. Come on, avoid him and jump and the second to last challenge. Boo hoo hoo. No, the ground is wet with the sad tears of my defeat. I hope you slip on them and fall all the way back to the first Sammer guy. That would stink, man. If I got hit by a Cursia again and got sent back to the beginning, that would stink so much. Man. Speaking of stinking, I'm actually going to be using... this has nothing to do with stinking. I'm going to be using a Super Shroom Shake just so I can feel confident. There we go. Okay. 38 HP. I can work with that. And so you arrive at last. It is this place you seek, the 100th gate. I am Endboss, greatest of all the Sammer guys. It is my duty as Endboss to laugh at your feeble party and proclaim your doom. Shall we begin, Challenger? Ha! You are pathetic. Prepare to be crushed as the universe withers. Round 100, the last round, fight. I will use carry. Okay. Let's time our jump. Nope, did not time our jump. He dealt 10 damage to us. I do want to beat this guy using normal means. I do, really do. Got him. I do not want to spam fire. That's beneath me. Okay, come on, buddy. Where are you? Buddy? Whoa! Jump. Oh, no. Oh, boy. Let's heal up. Oh, he's going to hit me with fire, isn't he? Maybe. Also, this is the first enemy that we've seen use fire besides Bowser. Okay, come on. Just because you're using it doesn't mean... I have a license to use it, and he's dead! Roll credits. How did I do? I've been preparing for my big scene for years. I was worried about that final line, though. Was it end boss enough? No, I knew I should have gone something about the wailing of all creatures. I was only worried that it would be too over the top. Enough talk. King Samur awaits you in the next room. Go now, champion. Man, he looks so cool. Looks so incredibly cool. Tiptron, what does this guy have about him that is interesting? That's End Boss, by far the most famous Samur guy in history. It's actually cool that there are Tiptron bios for all of these guys. He won a Sammy at last year's Samur Awards for Best Final Boss Performance. And in case you're wondering, my voice for him was slightly inspired by an antagonist from Dragon Ball Super, so I don't spoil it. There you go. Where he had some really cool lines this last episode. Ah, bravo! Our jaws are agape at the spectacle of your warrior prowess, challenger. I never imagined you'd be the victor. Did all that savage combat get boring? But I digress. I am true to my word, and I shall grant you my greatest treasures. You got the Goombella card, and the Koops card, and the Madame Flurry card, and the Yoshi card, and the Vivian card, and the Admiral Bobbery card, and the Miss Mouse card. Ahem. Well, you see, I had planned on bestowing our pure heart to you, but it's gone. Instead, I present you with these other royal treasures. My charity knows no bounds. Well, that's the end of that. Your battle is over. We're all most entertained. Should you find yourself in your kingdom again someday, do drop in for a melee. Farewell, champion. Wow, is that it? That's really it? I mean, that's cool. We got cards from Paper Mario, Thousand Year Door, but that's our reward? Huh. That's really all there is to it, isn't there? That's King Samur, regal monarch of the Great Samur Kingdom. He's considering turning the Duel of 100 into an amusement water park. Okay. I mean, that's interesting. Well, I guess that's it. It seems like there should be a bigger ending, but no. We've completed everything this game has to offer. We've seen that everything seemed to end well for everyone involved. Except Dementio, but everyone else. And yeah, this series has been a blast. I was a little bit apprehensive going into it because, you know, I have some reservations about the Mario series. The story is usually the same. The gameplay, I never was really that big of a fan of for the 2D platformers, but this game has impressed me. It's impressed me to the point where I would be supportive of doing another Paper Mario Let's Play someday. I don't know when, because I have my schedule of Let's Plays to come pretty well mapped out for the future, but I'm not against doing it. And if you guys are fine with that, as you seem to be from the comments, you guys have seemed to love this Let's Play, then I will be doing another Paper Mario game someday. But yeah, I've enjoyed this game a lot. And while there have been portions that I just flat out did not like the over there segments, the rest of the game I enjoyed thoroughly. And so, I think I've made my thoughts for this game pretty clear, so there's nothing really left to say. Thank you so much for watching. I have enjoyed this series, and I will be enjoying the next one, which will be coming out soon. I have to do the League of Legends and Overwatch videos, but rest assured that the series should come within due time. So, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys for the next Let's Play here on Super Paper Mario. Here on PalPlays. End of chapter and end of game. See ya. I need water. Oh, there's none left in my cup. My voice is so hoarse from that. Oh boy. Also, while I've been recording this on a Sunday afternoon, my parents are having company, and he has come. It's actually my grandfather who has come over, and I've been recording this entire time. So I'm going to go out and say hi to him. This goes to show the lengths of which I go to record. Well, once again, see you guys later for PalPlays! You thought I was going to say it, didn't you? Well, I'll see you guys then. Thank you.